and welcome to the start of another weekly reading vlog. I didn't do one last week, but now I'm back again. I'm completely ready to vlog my reading process again for you guys. And yeah, let me just, as usual, start off by telling you what I'm currently reading. So I am currently reading Muse of Nightmares by Lainey Taylor. I took the dust jacket off because it's easier with reading, but like, it's this beautiful red book. And oh my god, this book, it's really intense. Like, there's so much happening and it's amazing and I love it and it's just wonderful. I am now at page 378, so I'm quite a bit in this book now. And I'm definitely going to finish it this week because it's amazing and I need to know how it ends and I just love it so much. And I just don't, I'm like on the edge of my seat the entire time because I don't trust anything whilst reading this book. Like, there could be something around every corner. This book could destroy me like any minute. So it's definitely like very good but very intense. So yeah, loving this book. And I'm also listening to an audiobook, and I'm listening to Catching Fire by Suzanne Collins. I finished the audiobook of The Hunger Games last week, so I'm now continuing with the series with Catching Fire. One of my all-time favorite book series. I love it so much, and it has been like more than a year, like a year and a half since I last read it, so it was definitely time for another reread. And yeah, I'm listening to the audiobooks for the very first time and I'm really enjoying it, and I still love this book series so much. And yeah, I'm really flying through the audiobooks. I'm pretty sure I can finish this one this week as well, even though I've only just started with it. And then after that, I'm definitely listening to Mockingjay, and yeah, I'm just rereading so many of my favorite series at the moment and it's making me very happy. And yeah, today I basically have a filming day. I just filmed my review for Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets, and I'm going to do some more videos this afternoon. So I need like to change my outfit and my lipstick a couple of times. But yeah, I really plan today as a filming day so I can pre-film some stuff, and then the rest of the week I can focus more on school. And tonight I have to go to work again, and yeah, that's pretty much my like exciting plan for today. Also, if you have any video requests, please let me know. I would love to hear about them, and I always can use more filming inspiration. So yeah, let me know what you like to see me film. But now it's time for lunch, and yeah, I'm very hungry. So yeah, time for some food, and then after that, more filming. So a couple of outfit changes later, I've now filmed some videos, so that's nice. And I feel a bit sleepy today, I don't know why, but I did read a little bit more of Muse of Nightmares, and I'm still loving it, and I just don't want it to end. But then on the other hand, I also really want to know like what the ending is. I know, hard feelings and everything. It's really tough to be a book lover. And I have about an hour until I have to go to work, and I think I'm just going to give myself some free time until then because I don't feel like being productive right now. And just watch a little bit of Netflix. I've been watching Brooklyn Nine-Nine and it's so funny. I really love it. And tonight, then after work, I will definitely read more of Muse of Nightmares, and I cannot wait for it. I'm already like looking forward to it, and yeah, I cannot wait to finish that book. Hey, so it's the next morning, and last night I read more of Muse of Nightmares. I'm now at page 433. So yeah, I have about like 100 pages left, and oh my god. That's basically the sentiment for this entire book. Just oh my god, what's happening? Oh my god. I'm loving it even more than I loved Stranger Dreamer. I didn't know that was possible, but I do. But I guess that's also a little bit of an unfair comparison, because of course with Stranger Dreamer, the entire world had to be set up and the characters had to be introduced. So it's a little bit more slow paced. There's less action or less exciting stuff happening than in Muse of Nightmares, because of course here we already know the characters. We're already invested into the story. So I guess that's why I like Muse of Nightmares even more, because I'm just so like, oh, I want to know what happens next and I want to know how this is going to end. But I am happy, I guess, that it's a duology, because if there would be another book, I don't know how I would stand the wait for like another book. And I think this is the perfect size for this story, at least so far. I don't know how it's going to end. Maybe I will regret saying those words, but it's just so amazing and I want to keep reading it, and I don't have the time today to just read and do nothing else. So that's unfortunate, but I'm going to read more of it tonight and hopefully finish it. I'm really going to try, and I don't know, I can stand another day without knowing how it's going to end. So yeah, pretty excited about this book. And yeah, this is definitely one of my favorite books of the year so far. Also, Catching Fire, I'm already about halfway through because I'm really flying through the audiobook, as I said. And yeah, not much to add to that, except of course that it's one of my all-time favorite series and I still love it. And it's definitely a series I just want to reread every once in a while and I just never get tired of it. And I do think that this book series still holds up very well. But like some book series that were written about 10 years ago, I don't know when The Hunger Games was written, but it has been a while. You sometimes get the feeling like, oh, this doesn't age well, like it's definitely not written today, like except with the first few Mortal Instruments books, you really get that feeling. I mean, they're still good, but you get the feeling that they have aged a little bit, so that's why I think the later books are better. But with The Hunger Games, I think they're still just really good books and they just hold up so well, and I still love the message, I still love the story, it's still so exciting and heartbreaking. And yeah, I just think it's a very good series and it's a lot more timeless than some other early YA series, at least in my opinion. Maybe you disagree with me, but of course. Yeah, that's enough chatting for right now. I have to go get back to schoolwork, some editing, whatever, you know, just the daily life. And I will talk to you again soon. Yeah, I finished Muse of Nightmares last night and oh my god, this book is insane. I loved it so much. This entire duology is one of the best I've ever read, and this is now like one of my new all-time favorite series. I love it so much and I love everything about it. Like the writing is just extraordinary, like it's so beautiful and so captivating, and I think my favorite writing ever. And yeah, I'm just like sort of stunned and I don't really have words yet to really describe this book, but it's really good, really beautiful. And yeah, I can definitely recommend this series if you haven't picked it up yet, because it's really good. And yeah, the one thing I can say is that maybe Strange Dreamer is a little bit slower at the beginning, as I said, but Muse of Nightmares, it's so intense, it's so amazing. Whew, I really loved it. Then the next book I picked up is Lady Midnight by Cassandra Clare, because of course I still have to reread the first two books in the Dark Artifices series. Queen of Air and Darkness comes out in not a very long time, actually. It's a little bit more than a month now. So excited for that. It's going to be amazing. That book is also like going to be so good. I already know it. So yeah, just good books all around. And of course I love Lady Midnight. It's a reread, so I know I will love this. And yeah, very happy to be rereading it again. Somehow I remember less about Lady Midnight and Lord of Shadows than with the other books. I don't know why, but I'm very excited to experience it again. And yeah, just very happy about all the things that I'm reading. This morning though, I went to the gym and I was very happy about that. I felt really good about myself. But then in the afternoon, I really didn't plan it like that. I really didn't want it, but I just fell asleep for 2 hours. I don't know, I just drifted off and I fell asleep and I woke up 2 hours later. And it was a really good nap, but yeah, I sort of wasted a big part of my day and I'm a little bit sad about that, because I wanted to do some school stuff and now I did lose some time. Yeah, I'm just going to do a little bit right now, but yeah. Maybe I really needed that sleep, I don't know. I never do that. I don't fall asleep for like 2 hours. Sometimes I do a little nap of like 30 minutes at most. But now I was really deep asleep for 2 hours, so yeah, that was a little bit weird. But yeah, it's also like not the end of the world, so yeah, I did really have a good nap, so I guess I can be happy about that. But yeah, now really time to be productive, because yeah, I did have my resting time, so now I have to do some stuff. So yeah, let's do that. Hey, it is now Thursday and yeah, today I'm just like sort of like in my chill clothing and I didn't feel like putting makeup on, and yeah, I'm just going to try to do some more school stuff. It's a bit weird because like it is sort of like a holiday or like a vacation right now in the Netherlands. So my sister doesn't have school, my mother who is a teacher doesn't have to go to work. So yeah, it's a bit more like relaxed at home. And then I also feel like sort of having a vacation, but I still need to do some stuff. So yeah, I'm going to try today and hopefully I can manage to, yeah, do what I want to do today. Then also, I am almost done with the audiobook of Catching Fire. I have like 50 minutes left, so yeah, almost done with that. And yeah, I'm just really enjoying this reread and it's going so fast. Like, I really love the audiobook because I'm just listening to it whenever I can. And yeah, I just love this book series so much, as I've said multiple times already. And then after I finish Catching Fire, I will go straight on to Mockingjay and just finish my reread. I think I might actually finish it before October is over, so I can have like the entire series in my October wrap-up. And I've also been reading a little bit of Lady Midnight, but not a lot, but I think I want to read more of it tonight. So yeah, let's just see how that goes. And yeah, I'm really enjoying all of my books. Like, it's a lot of rereads. I think it's just a lot of rereads this month. But yeah, I'm very happy with that. So yeah, I just really love my favorite book series and I can never get enough of them. So I didn't film much yesterday, but this morning I actually went to the hairdressers. And it's not like you can see a huge change or anything. It was just a touch up, like getting my roots done and a little bit of a haircut. But you know, it looks nice because it's washed and dried at the hairdressers and it always looks so much better than when I do that myself. And yeah, of course, it's also always really relaxing. And whilst I was at the hairdressers and I had to wait for the dye to do its magic, I was reading Lady Midnight again. I'm now about this far in. I don't know what page, I believe around page 180. And yeah, very happy with this reread, as I said before. But also very exciting, I finished Catching Fire this morning, the audiobook. So yes, another book finished, which makes me really excited. And then, as I said before, I think it's just going on to Mockingjay right now. And yes, I think I can finish my reread of the Hunger Games series really soon, probably somewhere next week. And yeah, that makes me really happy. So yeah, reading is going fine. I don't really have anything else to tell you right now, I think. I'm just going to do some editing right now and then this afternoon I have to go to therapy again. And yeah, I don't really have anything planned apart from that. I do have a fun weekend planned though, because this Sunday, so not tomorrow but the day after that, I'm going to Amsterdam with my sister. We're going for a day of shopping and yeah, having lunch and some food and just having a really nice time together. We do this like a couple of times a year and I believe I've vlogged it before. But yeah, we're also going to Waterstones, of course, because I have to go to Waterstones Amsterdam. So yeah, you can come book shopping with me. I will probably film a little bit whilst I'm there. And yeah, that's pretty much all I have to tell you right now. So let's get on to editing and yeah, that's pretty much it. It is now evening and I'm home by myself, so I'm watching a movie downstairs in the living room. I'm actually watching Hocus Pocus because I've never seen it before. It's apparently this like Halloween classic and a very funny film. And yeah, so far I'm liking it. It's definitely funny and yeah. We don't celebrate Halloween here in the Netherlands, so yeah, this is probably the only Halloween-like thing I'll do, because we just don't do it here. It's not really a thing. But I've wanted to watch this movie for a while now, and yeah, watching it in the week before Halloween seemed like a good time. So yeah, just watching a movie and yeah, really enjoying it. Hey, so it is Saturday morning and today is going to be quite a boring day. I just did some school stuff and now after this, I think I'm just going to edit my videos for next week. But I wanted to give you an update on my reading, because yesterday night I very randomly started another book. And that book is Mistress of Rome by Kate Quinn. So this book is about the ancient Roman Empire. It takes place during that time. And it's about a slave girl named Tia and about a gladiator named Arius. And yeah, I just really felt like picking this up all of a sudden, and I started reading it and I couldn't put it down. I read 70 pages of it before I went to sleep. I was just so instantly hooked to it straight away. And yeah, I think I will be continuing this later in the afternoon when I have more time. And I just love the sort of idea of this book. I mean, like, it's about a slave girl and a gladiator, so it's pretty brutal, because of course when that's your life in the ancient Roman Empire, it's not a very happy life. So it's pretty brutal and intense, but I'm loving it. And yeah, I really loved Kate Quinn's book The Alice Network, so that's why I wanted to pick this up. And yeah, so far I'm very happy with it, very pleasantly surprised. I mean, I hoped it would be good, but so far it has met my expectations, so that's really nice. And I don't know what it is with her writing style, but it's just so addictive. And yeah, I just want to read it. Like, I just want to keep on reading it. So yeah, very happy with this. Yeah, I don't really read a lot of historical fiction that takes place during like ancient times. That's what makes this so interesting, because I don't know, do you have a lot of those books? If you know another book that takes place during like Roman times, please let me know. And I also want to do a video about historical fiction books really soon, so if this book is any good, then it will probably make the list. And then yeah, I'm also still listening to the Mockingjay audiobook, which is of course like great because I love The Hunger Games, as I've said many times before in this video already. I will say though, Mockingjay is my least favorite out of the three. Yeah, it's just, I don't know, it's my least favorite. Still good, but not the best of the series. And now I'm going to continue with my boring Saturday plans. Not a lot of excitement. But as I said before, tomorrow I will be going to Amsterdam shopping, book shopping, eating food and cake and yeah, lots of unhealthy stuff. And having some quality time with my sister, which is really nice because I just always like it when we hang out together. And yeah, I'm sure tomorrow will be a lot of fun. Already Monday, but I forgot to end the reading vlog yesterday. So yeah, I had a fun time in Amsterdam and I bought some new clothes, this sweatshirt amongst them, and also some books. I had a really fun time at Waterstones. I always love going there. So yeah, it was a fun day and it was really nice to just be away for a little while and yeah, I had a fun time shopping. And then also this weekend I read a lot more of Mistress of Rome, and yeah, I'm still really enjoying that book. I'm really like getting into it. It's so like brutal but also so fascinating. So yeah, I will be continuing to read that book this week. But this is it now for this reading vlog, and if you like this video, maybe go subscribe or give it a thumbs up. I would really appreciate that. And then hopefully I will see you again very soon in my next video. Bye.